And I think it would be appropriate to just take a minute to reminisce about our first French kisses. I remember Pam Orzak from Trumbull, Connecticut. She was in eighth grade, and I was in sixth. And she wrote me this note that said, "You're my daddy, so I can dress feed you," because she was dyslexic. This is true, you can't really make this up. It would be sort of rude. And it turns out my buddy Goose is also dyslexic, although he didn't realize it until I started telling this story once in a while on stage, and then he's like, "I'm not dyslexic, I just sometimes mix up my B's and my D's." I was like, "That's dyslexic." There I am. It must have been tough. He's like, "Left, okay, all right." I mean, we're not taking any shots at dyslexia, of course. It's cold. So I was scared because I didn't want to breastfeed at 10. Past the age of breastfeeding and prior to the age where you're really, like, comfortable.
My first French kiss was in 10th grade. I was a bit of a late bloomer, and I was with a girl named Samantha Moss. Samantha? And it took place in a laundry room on top of a washing machine. But the washing machine was orange. And it was wonderful. And then my friend Kyle Riapko talks about his cousin.
I was a very young boy in Canada, and my mother babysat all girls, only girls, and I used to walk home with them after school and go home and make out with them. Bob Lines. One, two.